won't be caught dead playing roads and boats. When people make him mad, he wants to punch him in the throats.
Hey folks, welcome back to another installment of my top 100 games of all time. This time it's going to be numbers 60 through 51, the very top part of the bottom half of my list. So still having a lot of cool games that we're starting to get into, a lot of really, really cool games as we go further down into my list. But I think there's going to be a lot of surprises on here, a lot of shifts, but I think you'll understand that as we continue to go throughout the segments. So without further ado, let's get to it. So my number 60, the last time I did this list was my number 10. So 2 years ago, Level 7 Omega Protocol was number 10, and now it is number 60. And really the only things that I can attribute that to is not in a drop in my liking the game. It's more just simply, I don't play it as much as I would like to now. And there are other games out there that I also enjoy playing that are kind of in the same genre. I think it's still my sci-fi go-to as far as dungeon crawlers are concerned. But some new games have kind of cropped up, and it's kind of taken its spot. I don't play dungeon crawlers as much as I used to, and so there's a lot of different things going to it. It's still a great game. I still really enjoy it. I think there's a lot of value in the game. It just has slipped, in my estimation, for a number of personal reasons. Nothing against the game at all. Level 7 Omega Protocol is still a great game. I love how the Overlord works. I love how all of the different, I don't know, I guess you could say surprises happen within the game. I really enjoy the game. I just think it's slipping a little bit because of a lack of time play, and other things are garnering my attention right now. So Level 7 Omega Protocol, my number 60, still a great game, but it has fallen a little. So my number 59 is another one that has fallen a lot. It was number 14 back in 2014, and that is Kemet. Now, Kemet, I enjoy. I like the Egyptian theme that it has on it. I like the area control aspect. I like that turtling is not really a good thing that you can do. You have to kind of get out there and attack and take other places over, so you can't really just sit back. I like how you can upgrade your troops and all of that kind of stuff. I like a lot about it. I've just played it once in a year. The last time I played this game was literally back at BGGCon in 2015. So it slipped mainly because of that reason, but it's still a really great game. I really enjoy it. My number 59, Kemet. Now, my number 58 is actually usually mentioned in almost the same breath as my number 59, and that is Cyclades, or however you pronounce that name. I like this one just a smidge better than Kemet, simply because I like the pantheon that's used here a little bit better than in the Egyptian pantheon. I know there's some crossover now with some expansions that have come out for Cyclades and Kemet, but I still like the base game just a little bit better than I do Kemet. They're played very similarly, I guess you could say, but I really enjoy Cyclades a lot better. That's why it's at 58 and not 59 Cyclades. My number 57 is a World War II tactical game called Heroes of Normandy. This is a new one, an addition to the list. I really enjoy this. Jan and Klim did a great job in designing this game. It is very tactical, it's very strategic, but it's also very fun. You can just try some things that are kind of offhanded, don't really work, probably in real life, so to speak, but it's still a really fun game, and it still has that tactical strategic feel that a war game should have, but yet the fun factor is still there, and the design of the game is very cartoony, almost a Hollywood version of a war game, if you wanted to go that far. So I really enjoy Heroes of Normandy. It is probably one of my favorite war-ish type games, and solidly coming into the list on number 57, Heroes of Normandy. My number 56 is a very light dice-chucking game, and that's one of my go-to kinds of games, I guess you could say, but this one has a really neat feel on it. It's called Ultimate Warriors. Now, this has almost like a wrestling, professional wrestling, WWE, WWF, whatever you want to call it, feel to it, but you're monsters and you're different kinds of warriors from different factions and walks of life. And I thought it was a really interesting take on this whole idea of just monsters battling each other. You know, we have King of Tokyo and King of New York, which are fine and dandy, but this one just has a little bit of a different feel. First things is right out of the box, your people, your monster has a special ability, has its own deck of cards that it uses, and I really enjoy games that do that. It gives you differentiation from everybody else. And so Ultimate Warriors really hit high on this list. My first entry of the list, number 56, Ultimate Warriors. My number 55 is a game that has also fallen a lot from 2014. It was my number 12 back then, and X-Wing, the miniatures game, is still a great game, still one that I enjoy. Now, I play it mondo casually. I do not get into it as deeply as many people have. I'm definitely not a tournament player or anything like that. I couldn't tell you what sets that I like to take and what ships work well with one another and all of that kind of stuff. I just like to sit down and say, you know what, I'm gonna use this guy, this guy, this guy, this guy, and these ships, and this is what we're gonna do. You pick yours and we're gonna go at it. Now, of course, we adhere to this, the points and everything like that, but the idea is that I'm in no way a competitive player of this. I just love flying my X-Wings and B-Wings and A-Wings and TIE Fighters and all of this stuff around him with the Falcon. So I just really enjoy the game. It has a great aesthetic appeal to it. Just one of my favorite games to just sit down and play and have fun with. And so that is number 55. It has fallen from a 12 position simply because I don't have nearly the time that I should probably attribute to a number 12 list. And I don't attribute that much time to this game anymore, but I still really enjoy it. X-Wing. My number 54 is a game that has replaced Agricola for me. I'll no longer play Agricola simply because Caverna exists. Now, Caverna has also fallen. And again, it's a heavier game. I don't own the game. That's another big thing for it as well. So I don't get to play it as often. I'm reliant upon other people to play it, and it just doesn't hit the table very often because people don't bring it. So Caverna is one of my favorite I guess you could say small micro civ games, I guess you could say, where you're building your own little cottage into the side of a mountain and having to feed your family and all this other kind of stuff. It fell from number 16, but still I think a strong placement in my list. I think this is probably where it's going to find its home. My number 54, Caverna. My number 53 is a new addition to the list, and I think that's mainly because it came out with a new edition here just a few weeks, maybe a couple months ago. And really enjoy the new second edition. I love the fact that the app for Mansions of Madness now does all of that accounting for it. This was a game that I really enjoyed, but I didn't like all of the accounting. And now that they have an app on a device for the all of the different accounting, you know, keeping track of damage for monsters and how much damage you have and all of this kind of stuff, I love that it does that. So it debuted on my list, number 53. Now, you might say, well, if you like it so much, why is it so low? Understand that this is very near the middle of a list of 100 games that I really enjoy. So this is definitely higher up there than some of the other games, of course. So Mansions of Madness, I'm not really a fan of the whole Cthulhu theme and cultists and all that kind of stuff. But this one, the whodunit aspect of the game, I like the sleek nature of the app that is now in it. The models that come in the game are all phenomenal. It's very well produced. This is a game that I really can sink my teeth into. Number 53, Mansions of Madness. Now, my number 52, after talking about such a huge game like Mansions of Madness, might seem a little bit out of place because this game only has basically a few cards and a few dice that come in the game. It's just a very simple dice rolling game. But the theme is what really grabs it for me, and the quality of the dice is what really grabs it for me, and that is Age of War. Now, in Age of War, it takes place in feudal Japan, and basically all the different players are vying for control over these different castles that are spread throughout the island. And once the last castle is conquered, whoever has the most points wins. But the way that you have to conquer the castle is by rolling the dice, and it's very tactical how you can how you're supposed to use the different dice and certain times and all this kind of stuff. Saying it's a tactical game is really probably a misnomer, but that's the way it feels for me. So I really enjoy Age of War. It's one of my go-to filler games on a game night. So that is my number 52, Age of War. My number 51 is a game that I talk a lot about, and a new standalone expansion just came out this year for it, and I really enjoyed that expansion and what it did for the game. But my number 51 is Dead of Winter. Now, you might say, Sam, you really talk a lot about this game. Why isn't it higher on your list? Well, it is a little bit of a longer game, and it does take a certain number of people, at least in my opinion, to enjoy the game. So it is a little bit harder to teach, so it loses its gateway accessibility. So it's a little bit harder to reach the table. But as far as zombie games go, and as far as social deduction games go, it's really pretty high up on my list. And my number 51, Dead of Winter. So that is my 60 to 51 for my top 100 games of all time. We're now done with the top half of the list. Now we're going to get down to the nitty gritty in the upcoming episodes. Only five more segments left till we get to the top 10. So hang on with me, stay with me. Thank you for joining me, and we'll see you on the next segment later on, y'all.
Thanks so much for watching the Dice Tower videos. Find more great videos and reviews, as well as our top-rated audio podcast at Dicetower.com. You can also find other great shows at Dicetowernetwork.com. I'm Eric Summerer, and you've been watching the Dice Tower. The Dice Tower is sponsored by Cool Stuff, Inc., where you can find great games for great prices. Cool stuff in stock. Check them out at CoolStuffInc.com.